It's time to review the world's smallest Ethernet switch from Brian Huang, and we're going to make this a 2-minute design review. Now, we only have Gerber files for this, so we're taking a look at the fab data. Here in your top layer copper, I see that you have a big Ethernet transformer, and you do need this because these connectors are not RJ45 mag jacks. From looking at your copper, I don't see any chassis ground, so you can't use shielded connectors to help protect against ESD. Make sure your ESD testing assesses the data line as well as any other exposed connection to the system ground. Next, when I look at your Ethernet PHY chip, I see that you have an exposed die-attach pad on the top layer, but when I look at your internal layers, I see that you have thermal connections to all of your thermal vias. You'll want to get rid of all of these thermal reliefs on these layers, because the whole point of having thermal vias is to have heat transfer into the internal layers of your PCB. I also see that you have some thermal connections on some of these passives below your Ethernet transformer. I would recommend removing all of those thermal connections on your outer layers unless you're going to be hand soldering these components. Of course, if this is truly the world's smallest Ethernet switch, you're going to want to mass produce this thing, and that means it's going to go through reflow soldering, not hand soldering. You have some mask openings that are getting a little close to the edge of the board. You have some silkscreen falling right onto your mask openings, which means silkscreen is getting printed right onto copper pads. I see that you did include some fab info with some dimensions here and some mounting hole outlines and a board outline, and it's a good thing that you did that, but you forgot the most important stuff. You forgot a drill drawing, a stackup drawing, and fabrication notes. You can put all of this information into your VScore layer, and then it will get included with your Gerber export. You can also convert your VScore layer and your edge cuts layer into a DXF file and use that to create a PDF file of your drawing. Make sure to send me the world's smallest Ethernet switch after you manufacture it. Want to have your design reviewed on the channel? Find me on LinkedIn and send me your design files or your manufacturing files.